Hey everyone, me Kevin here. Here's an update on the next stimulus package and the EIDL grants. As usual, remember, deposit $100 with Webull to get 4 free stocks worth at least $21 and get $30 with M1 Finance. Use both of them. M1 Finance has great uses as well. Just deposit $100 there and $30 will show up for you. Now, let's get started. There's a lot of talk going around that Joe Biden is not upholding his promise to do $2,000 stimulus checks because he's considering the $600 to be part of the $2,000 checks. Representatives like AOC are demanding that $2,000 means $2,000. Yet, when we last talked about $2,000, it was very clear that the $2,000 check plan was an amendment, that it would go from $600 to an extra $1,400. Yet, Biden is already now losing Democrats who say, no, $2,000 is $2,000, bro. You said $2,000, we want $2,000. No matter how you slice and dice it, we want a new $2,000. But then on the flip side, you got people like Joe Manchin who are like, look, the only way he would even consider the $1,400 plus up to equal $2,000 in total is if the $1,400 were targeted to fewer people than last time. So you've already got this war basically happening within the Democratic Party. It's almost like as soon as the Republicans became less of an issue or became less of an enemy or less of a threat, the Democrats who were united against the Republicans are now divided against each other. It's a disaster. Welcome to politics. This is why we need aliens to have, like, a planet right outside of, or right next to ours or something, so that we're always united against them. Except, hopefully, they just never invade. Anyway, let's keep talking about stimulus. The reality is, at this point, I don't believe that we're going to see a full $2,000. I don't believe what we're going to see a Ro Khanna or Ed Markey push for $2,000 per month. As much as these things would be great for the economy and great for people who are especially struggling, at this point, Joe Biden's push, his big push, is for the extra $1,400. Everything else is apparently political clickbait to encourage support for future donations. Look, Democrats do this, and so do Republicans. Donald Trump famously did it himself when he said, hey, if we want $2,000 stimulus checks and we don't want all this money going to foreign countries, donate to my fund. Remember, that was an email he sent out when he stopped and refused to sign the $600 stimulus package until 2K checks were in it. Of course, he ended up signing the $600 package the way it was. Moving on, the focus right now is heavily on childcare. Biden wants to see all K-8 grade schools open within the first 100 days of his administration, with $130 billion going to make that happen. And this will include, finally, like, I don't know if the gods sent them this message or they're watching our YouTube videos here, but how many times have I been talking about, please get some frickin' ventilation systems? Like, if we had high-quality ventilation, we wouldn't have to lock down as much. Well, here we go. This $130 billion will finally include, quote, new ventilation systems. Thank the Lord. Jeez. Along with help for additional teaching programs to, quote, make up for lost learning time this year. Joe Biden's plan also boosts childcare funding for childcare facilities from $10 billion to $40 billion, $25 billion of which will go directly to childcare providers. Additionally, Biden's push for the $15 per hour minimum wage is also solidifying. According to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, 68% of minimum wage workers were women in 2019. Increasing the minimum wage is now being seen as a way to reduce the gender pay gap between men and women. On the note of men versus women, some are now calling this current COVID recession a she-session. Given the damage to hospitality jobs, lower wage jobs, bureaucrat jobs, childcare jobs, travel jobs, and all of which skew heavily towards women. This is in contrast to the 2008 recession, which some are now calling a man-session, given the damage to financial services. Biden's push for a minimum wage may be in part inspired by trying to reduce the gender pay gap. After all, he runs heavily on the premise of equity, equality between races and genders. However, this push does not come for free. Not only does it cost money for businesses, but the Congressional Budget Office believes that raising the minimum wage to $15, based on their report in 2019, would actually lead 1.3 million people who would otherwise have a job without a job, because businesses would have to cut jobs to support higher pay. But unfortunately, evidence for this is mixed. Some say, like the 2018 study by the Economic and Social Research Institute in Ireland, that yeah, we actually did see the pay gap between men and women shrink when we had this larger minimum wage. But other studies have found the exact opposite. So as is typical, it'll all just come down to politics and fingers crossed that it works the way it's intended to work without causing too much damage. Now, not only is not having a gender pay gap reduced a risk factor, but the bigger risk factor right now is political, and that's that Republicans argue by increasing the minimum wage, we're actually burdening small businesses with higher wages at the same time as businesses need the most help. And especially since Biden's plan doesn't include a new, larger, and even more expanded PPP to, rather than funding businesses in a second round for another 8 to 24 weeks, does something more permanent or long-term for these businesses, or at least we haven't yet seen those details. We've heard a rumor that maybe there'll be $175 billion set aside for loans, but we haven't seen that yet, and therefore a lot of Republicans are like, what are you talking about? Why are we even considering raising the minimum wage in the middle of a recession? Obviously, Democrats counter and say, because people need the money. Now, there are also reports that if Biden chooses to go with the 51-vote budget reconciliation method to pass the next stimulus package, using basically only Democrats who are in power now, that the process might take substantially longer. That is, the budget recon process takes longer than a normal bill that would get passed via the normal 60 votes in the Senate. And this is despite Biden saying that, look, there's no time to waste. And maybe that's exactly why Biden right now is trying to get the 60 votes rather than use the budget recon process. But to get to 60 votes, Biden's going to have to negotiate hard with Mitch McConnell, and we already know how that goes. Getting 60 votes at this point seems very difficult, especially when we look at people like Brian Rindel. He's a budget expert at the, they kind of lean towards the right a little bit, but anyway, at the Manhattan Institute, he had a quote here. He goes, "I see no way 10 Republican Senate votes in its current form. There are too many poison pills." We know, for example, Republicans are highly opposed to the $15 minimum wage, along with any bill really costing over $1 trillion. As a result, Bloomberg Intelligence believes that this stimulus package, no matter what Biden does, will end up getting negotiated down to under $1 trillion or around $1 trillion. Bloomberg Intelligence says they see little hope of this $1.9 trillion package actually passing. But again, Democrats like Bernie Sanders and Bernie Sanders' staff are saying, no, we're going to use the budget recon process, and we kid you not, the $1.9 trillion is going to happen. Well, folks, buckle up. We're in for a ride. In other news, the SBA has updated their website after a long wait in saying that we were going to see an update on the 17th of January. We finally got an update. The update came on January 18th. But the update was, I'll just read it to you. Remember this, we've long been waiting for the SBA to provide new guidance on the new EIDL grants, the EIDL grants. We're expecting to see the EIDL advance portal open up again so people could get $1,000 per employee or possibly up to $10,000, depending on how they interpret the rules, which, you know, the SBA generally doesn't interpret the rules in our favor. They tend to be a little bit more strict against our favor. But anyway, we know that the $10,000 EIDL grants are expected to go to people who are making or have an economic decline or can prove an economic decline of 30% and who live in low-income communities. Well, the SBA updated their website to give us the latest, and here's what they said. Quote, "The SBA is preparing to offer shuttered venue operator grants," that's for Save Our Stages, "and targeted EIDL advance with limited eligibility." And then the second line they updated, "The SBA previously offered the following funding options, EIDL advance, no longer available." Wow, it sounds to me like the SBA is basically preparing to screw everybody again out of getting even the $1,000 per employee, at least based on the latest change to the SBA website. Obviously, we'll have to stay tuned to what's going on over at the SBA's website to see what the heck is actually going to happen. But for right now, we are on standby even longer, as usual, thanks to the SBA, well, sucking.